Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the invocation by Dr. John Wheeler, chaplain of the university.
Let us pray. Almighty God, on the sea of your love, speed these graduates with the winds of good fortune to the isles of opportunity and give them peace. Give them peace in their hearts, having found the meaning and purpose of life. Give them peace of mind, having learned that they can cope with life and succeed. Give them peace in their souls, having found for themselves the life of faith, hope, and love. And God, give us peace in the world, having determined to live free and to proclaim liberty to all. In your mighty name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. It is a great pleasure to welcome the families and friends of the graduates, community friends, and our distinguished guests to the most important and probably the most anticipated event of our academic calendar, graduation. The photography area is available to my right, so that families may photograph the students. Please come up, take your pictures, and as a courtesy to others, return to your seat so that everyone may have that same opportunity. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce the president of Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University, General Kenneth L. Talbot, President Talbot.
Thank you, Dr. Williams. Members of the graduating class, parents, friends, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to add my welcome to each of you here this morning. You know, every year we are blessed with a commencement speaker whose message can provide inspiration to someone heading out on their own, like you're about to do. I can assure you that this year is no exception. For the person I'm about to introduce is a close friend who I know has inspired many young people starting their career. I'm extremely pleased that General Charles Sam and his lovely wife, Sandra, are able to be with us today at this most important event in the academic year at Embry-Riddle. General Ham, who is presently the superintendent of the United States Air Force Academy, has served a distinguished career as an Air Force pilot, a commander, a military advisor, and now an educational administrator. Native of Little Rock, Arkansas, he's held over 20 different assignments in the Air Force, ranging from flying the left wing position for the Thunderbird to serving as the senior United States military attaché to the Soviet Union. Prior to achieving his present leadership position at the Air Force Academy, General Ham served as Vice Commander of the Air Training Command at Randolph Air Force Base in Texas, and as many of you know, that's the command that's responsible for all the pilot training in the Air Force. He's a graduate of West Point, received a master's degree in political science from Auburn University, as a graduate of the National War College. General Ham's present assignment as the 11th superintendent of the Air Force Academy carries with it a great responsibility, as I'm sure you can appreciate. The responsibility of both the thousands of young men and women who are educated there and in the nation that it prepares them to serve. So, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor to introduce a friend and a colleague who serves the nation with both professionalism and dignity.
General Charles Hale.
Thank you, General Tallman. It's a great personal pleasure to be with you again. General Tallman is not only an old friend, he's a hero of mine. And he is a standard setter for superintendents at the Air Force Academy that we've tried to live up to since his departure. I have no illusions about people coming to graduations to listen to what the graduation speaker has to say. So I will be brief. Not as brief as one speaker I heard about. It happened about 34 years ago. A good friend of mine was graduating from Air Force pilot training. Prevailed upon his father-in-law, who happened to be the chief of staff of the Air Force, General Nate Twining, to come down and speak at the graduation. And the chief got up and said something like this. He said, "Flying down from Washington, I thought about what I was going to say. I thought about all the thousands of speeches I'd heard in my life. That I couldn't remember anything really important that anyone ever said. I do remember some speeches were short, and some were long, and shorter was better. So, fly safe and happy landing." Well, I'm not going to let you off that easy, Dave. But I would like to not address the graduates, but talk to the graduates. And just talk about two things. Your purpose, the purpose of the college, they fulfill that, and I have no doubt for what they have, is through comprehensive education to prepare you to be responsible citizens and prepare you for successful careers in aviation and aerospace. Let me talk about just two of those aspects, being responsible citizens and having a productive career. For the first part, I'd like to borrow from an author, Robert K. Greenlee, who wrote a wonderful book back in the 70s called Servant Leadership. It has to do with the idea that leaders are better when their desire to serve, their desire to lead, springs from the desire to serve. Robert K. Greenlee, Servant Leadership. I recommend you study that book. In it, Greenlee talks about the responsibilities of citizens. He says college should prepare people to serve and be served by society. And he says, responsible citizens should set out to change the world, in his words, to make it more in accord with virtue and justice. And he says, one of the things you have to do in order to be able to do that is you have to cope with the bureaucracy. Now, you've all been a part of the bureaucracy. You're going to continue to be a part of the bureaucracy, large or small. He says you need to develop an attitude, a lifestyle, he calls it, for coping with the bureaucracy. And he says, I define my lifestyle with five words: tolerance, openness, beauty, momentaneity, and humor. Of tolerance, he says, you need to learn to suffer with serenity. Indeed, you're going to be faced with hardship. Some of you will be faced with disasters, and you need to be tough. You need to be tough enough to press on. Openness has to do with communication, and mainly with listening. There's another author, Tom Peters, in his book, Thriving on Chaos, talked about listening. And he says, think about all the compulsive talkers you've known. Have you ever known a compulsive listener? Try to be one. Beauty. Not speaking of the beauty that poets write about, but the beauty that mathematicians, engineers, any kind of problem solvers discover when they find just the right formula, just the right solution. It fits perfectly. It's beautiful. Momentaneity. Many people lose the opportunity of the day because they're tied up in the past. They're trying to relive a past that they can't regain. Or they're so thinking about a visionary future that might be that they miss today's opportunities. Carpe diem, seize the day.
finally, humor. Not the loud, guffawing humor that has a place, certainly, but the kind we need to take on this bureaucracy. In the words of the author, that quiet, inward smile when we regard the silly little creatures, half-made that we are. So then, these are five words that Greenleaf uses to describe a lifestyle for coping with the bureaucracy. Tolerance, openness, beauty, momentaneity, and humor. Think about that concept. I wish I had thought about it earlier in my life. I've had to cope with a lot of bureaucracy. Those five words probably don't fit you. Pick five that do, and develop your lifestyle. The other point I'd like to talk about is a productive career. And to give you a little advice in meeting my obligations as a graduation speaker. I've had a career in aviation, largely associated with flying, but I think it applies to most anything you're going to do. And I would just make three points. The first is, know your job. The second, strive for perfection. And the third, as you do one and two, save some time for fun with family and friends. Let me expand just a bit. Know your job. In the workaday world, there's no higher or more important accolade than he's a real pro, or she really knows her job. That doesn't just happen. It comes through hard work. James Michener, in an article about higher education written over 20 years ago, said, college does nothing more than to prepare an individual to re-educate himself as he goes through his career. So you're in the process now of re-educating yourself. For those of you who've had a struggle with the books, you'll probably be disappointed to learn that that struggle will continue, that quest for knowledge must go on if you're going to know your job. Strive for perfection. If I may use some personal experiences, when I was fortunate enough to be chosen to fly with the Thunderbirds a long time ago now, over 25 years ago, that was about the same time that lift was discovered. I found that with concentrated, hard, dedicated practice, most any proficient pilot could learn to be a formation acrobatic pilot. And I found that you didn't have to do it just right. You were far enough away from the crowd so that if you moved out of formation a little bit and you slowly and smoothly corrected back in, no one really knew the difference. But after my second or third air show, maybe it was because that little old lady came up to me and said, son, today you made me proud to be an American, I rededicated myself to a higher standard. And for myself, I set the goal of never moving an inch out of formation during an air show. Well, it was an impossible goal, and as you might imagine, I never accomplished it. But by setting that high standard, I was a better formation acrobatic pilot. Later in my career, when I was an instructor at our Top Gun school, the Air Force Fighter Weapons School, I found that one of the real challenges as an instructor was to stay ahead of the students. They were hand-picked as the best in the world. So I set a goal there of planning the perfect mission, briefing the perfect mission, flying the perfect mission, and debriefing the perfect mission. I never did reach that goal either, but by aiming high, I was a better instructor. Strive for perfection. You'll be surprised how good you can get. As you do one and two, you're going to have to work hard, but you should also, in the vernacular, work smart. You need to work efficiently in order to save some time for fun with family and friends. As I look back on what's rapidly becoming a long career, I think not so much of the nifty airplanes that I flew or the neat places I was stationed, or the outstanding units or the important missions. I think mostly about the people I served with. People who were responsible citizens, who shared the same values I did, who took the good times and the bad times in stride. People who were excited, challenged, and rewarded by an aviation career. Looking back, I wouldn't trade places with anyone, but I do envy you. You're a great start on a great future. Congratulations, and good luck. And by the way, fly safe and happy landing.
Thank you, General Hamm. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, it is my pleasure to introduce Mr. Robert Rockett, the Dean of Student Affairs, to make a presentation. Dean Rockett. Each commencement, an outstanding graduating senior is selected to receive the President's Award. Candidates for this award of distinction are selected on the basis of academic excellence, campus activities, and the contributions to the university and the local community. These students are leaders who challenge others around them to think, to question, and to act. Candidates for this award are selected on the basis of recommendations from the faculty, the staff, and the student body. Selection for this honor reflects campus-wide recognition of the recipient's outstanding achievements. This time I'd like to ask President Tom to join me at the stage.
I'm very pleased today to announce the senior who is receiving the President's Award, Robert Anthony McCabe. Will you please come forward?
Robert McKay has been an exemplary student and leader during his years at Embry River. He has maintained a 3.83 cumulative grade point average while performing superbly as a member of the varsity basketball team and serving as senior class treasurer. Mr. McKay is probably best known for his Hall of Fame. Rob has also been recognized here in Embry River through the Grand Milwaukee ERAU Scholar Athlete Award for Basketball and the Lillian Clark Meyer Memorial Scholarship. His student activities have included a tenure as class treasurer, service as a volunteer team tutor, assistance to the 1991 basketball team at statistician, and employment as the student assistant for the College of Continuing Education. Rob has also contributed his talents charitably to the American Red Cross. His career ambitions derive from his superb academic background. Rob's excellent credentials in aviation business administration will hopefully lead to a management training position with a large corporation. He also plans to continue his education in pursuit of a master's degree in business administration. We wish Rob the best of success in these pursuits and thank him for his contributions to Embry Riddle Aeronautical University.
Pleasure to introduce to you the president of the senior class, Patrick Cassidy. Patrick?
President Tallman, Dr. Williams, General Hamm, University Officers, Provost Martin and Fletcher, Deans, Directors and Administrators, members of the Board of Trustees and visitors, faculty and staff, family and friends, and my fellow graduates, good morning. Today we gather here to remember our time spent at Embry-Riddle, while at the same time realizing what our future holds for us. Remember our freshman year when we walked around campus with blank looks on our faces as we found ourselves being very lost. We remember our sophomore year as we knew just enough to be dangerous. And our junior year when we began to wonder which would run out first, our money or our sanity. And then our senior year when we finally think we had it all figured out They tell us it's time to start looking for a job so we can pay back the $30,000 or more of student loans that we've accumulated in 4 years. But today it is also a time to say thank you to those people that made a difference in our lives. To our parents most of all, because let's face it, without them, there would be no graduating class of fall 1990. To the rest of our family whom we depend so much on for support, and to our friends who helped us get by one day at a time. Let us also remember the faculty and staff who have prepared us so well to enter the world in which we will be called upon to make our mark. And now, with that in mind, I would like to take a moment to have the recipients of the Outstanding Faculty and Staff Awards to please stand. These are the people that represent those who made a difference in our lives while we were here, the ones we went to when we needed help or had a problem, and the ones who are willing to go that extra mile for a student. These are the people who set Embry-Riddle apart from other colleges and universities. Many say these are the best times of our lives, and maybe for today they are, but anyone who's still saying that 20, 10, 5, or even a year from now is doing something wrong, because in today's world, being young and intelligent makes anything possible. This is not the lotto. It takes more than a buck and a dream. It takes hard work and dedication, but when you win, the payoff is a heck of a lot better because you know you've earned it. Never be afraid to dream new dreams. Be afraid when you stop dreaming and stop looking for that pot of gold at the end of your rainbow. Never be afraid to take chances. Be afraid when you don't. When you decide you can't do something, you have already made a self-fulfilling prophecy come true. So never give up, because you should never regret having given it your all and failing, but you will always have to live with the nagging question, what if you never tried at all. So when you leave here, only look back to remember where you came from so you can remember where you are headed. And remember what Jack Hunt said, for most people, the sky's the limit. For us, it's only the beginning. And one other thing that my brother always said to me over the last 4 years when I had any problems, and I tried to get through day by day, thumbs up to all you and congratulations.
Embry-Riddle is fortunate to have several armed services commissioning programs active on the Daytona Beach campus. The Air Force ROTC detachment is the largest elective enrollment in any civilian institution in the country. The Army ROTC detachment is one of the highest growth programs in the nation. We're proud of these graduates who have become the newest second lieutenants in our nation's armed forces. At this time, I would like them to stand to be recognized. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we will present the candidates for degrees. Graduates completing their degree with honors will be recognized when their names are announced as they cross the stage. Graduates wearing white cords have achieved grade point averages of between 3.5 and 3.69 and are graduating cum laude. Graduates wearing red cords have achieved grade point averages of between 3.7 and 3.89 and are graduating magna cum laude. Graduates wearing gold cords have earned a grade point average of between 3.9 and 4.0 and are graduating summa cum laude. As the graduates cross the stage, they will be greeted by President Tallman, General Hamm, and Dr. John Morris, a member of our Board of Trustees.
The faculty of the College of Aviation Technology are pleased to present the candidates for the degrees of Associate in Science in Aeronautical Science, Bachelor of Science in Aeronautical Science, Associate in Science in Aircraft Maintenance, Bachelor of Science in Aeronautical Studies, Bachelor of Science in Airway Science, Associate in Aviation Maintenance Technology in Professional Aeronautics, and Bachelor of Science in Professional Aeronautics. The candidates will now come to the platform to receive their degrees.
Candidates for the degree of Associate in Aeronautical Science. Guillermo Hector Gutierrez. Gerardo R. Lopez. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Aeronautical Science. Gary Philip Adams. Joseph Maxwell Anthony. James M. Apice. Dean Askew. James William Basham. Ronald Scott Beard. Herschel Israel Barris. Mickey Lynn Boggs, Senior Class Comp. Michael Joseph Ritchie, Senior Class Comp. Colleen Carey. Patrick James Cassidy, President, Senior Class Council. Brian Patrick Cerny, Omicron Delta Kappa, Senior Class Council. David Allen Chipperson. John Alexander Clark, Second Lieutenant. Marcus Antonio Colon. Chad W. Connor. David E. Dempsey. Frederick Lawrence DeBall. Mark Trevor Dudley. Sean Eric Elliott. Nicholas Vincent Evelich.
Suzette M. Fenton. Richard Allen Fetchick, Jr. Corey Allen Fritz, Senior Class Marshal. Brian Burlington Grizzle. Christy Danielle Hosworth. Nicholas Kelly Hawkins. Mark Forth Herzberg. Rex Henry Hopkins II. Mark S. Iron. Mark David Jones. David L. Jones, Jr. Constantinos Kalatihikis. Thomas Joseph Kane, Jr. Suzanne J. Noblock. Richard Warren Moulton, Secretary, Senior Class Council. Greg S. Kukos. Joseph Paul LaMana. Mary Catherine Lamont. Mark Juan Bowman. Raymond Lee Luciano. Murdoch Malcolm McGregor III. James Michael Mayato, Jr. Daniel Joseph Mariotti. Second Lieutenant William Martinez, Senior Class Counsel. Raymond M. Mascaragnas. Robert J. McBride. Ron Francis McCann, Senior Class Counsel. Jody Raymond McGee, Senior Class Counsel. Michael Sean McGee. Thomas Edward Miller. Thomas John Miller. Carl Paul Nelson. Nicholson. Jose M. Nieves, magna cum laude, Omicron Delta Kappa, Wuzhou, 1990. Kenneth F. Novogratsky II. Eric Michael O'Donnell. Alan Kent Olson. Alex Douglas Pagan. Vladimir Tuggle. Sue Ellen Plum, Senior Class Counsel. William Michael Poland, Jr. Kurt Allen Chaney. Andrew J. Schwartzman. Eric Llewellyn Slaney. James Christopher Smith. Robert Kimmel Spees. Joseph Grove Underer. Roland Lee Vigard. Juan J. Dallas. Alan Jeffrey Wexler. Kenneth Paul Fight. Christopher Patrick Visa. Candidate for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Aeronautical Studies. David Lewis Bobbitt. Hoyt Evan Brown, Senior Class Counsel. James Allen Brown, II. Brent Allen Carter. Jose Enrique Chang. Suzanne S. Davison. James Oliver Dorchek. Derek Scott DeMercy. Michael Dennis Eady. Cynthia Helen Edwards. Brian Kenneth Engel. Louis Paul Fernandez. Joseph John Gallo. Second Lieutenant James Robert Glass, Senior Class Counsel. Michael Mark Jeffrey Green. Thomas John Gresser. Frederick Stanton Griffin. Ronald Robert Gupto. Christopher Paul Hepp. Stephen Eugene Hull. Second Lieutenant Michael Scott Lacken. Kenneth James Lindsley. Mark Allen Little. Walter Daniel Harris, Sigma Tau Delta. Amanda Jo Marsh. Christopher David McQuaid, cum laude. Lisa Marie Malasco. Michael A. Mueller. Timothy Edward O'Connor. Maria Sofia Palasco, senior class counselor. Jeffrey Brand Penn. Jeffrey William Phillips. David Amado Cui. Jeffrey Todd Reedy.
Oh, no.
Morris Patrick Riley III. Paul Robert Reynolds. Luke Dahlia Rivera. Daniel B. Ritardi. Matthew David Ruff. Gregory James Ryan, cum laude. Gordon Anthony Smith. Kimberly Ann Strum. James Carroll Taylor. Jerry Philip Cohn. Paul Allen Wade. Robert Paul Wasaki. Candidate for the degree of Associate in Science in Aircraft Maintenance. Richard Winton Boyd III. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Airway Science. Olaf Dacliff Brown. Eric Kent Kamaski. Mary A. Sheldon. Sabrina Geraldine Weber. Candidates for the degree of Associate in Aviation Management Technology. Seth Andrew Griffin. Robert Charles Savasso. Lance R. Kocher. John Michael Koss. Randy James Williams. Candidate for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Aviation Technology. Paul George Aquilino. Second Lieutenant Philip Clark Mejia Badar. J.D. Parrish Butch. David Scott Crabtree. Thomas Andrew Fish, Comali. Brian Keith Hirschman. Rohit Iyer. Eric A. Lacko. Magna Cum Laude. Matthew J. Martin, Cum Laude. Roland James McClellan Jr., Cum Laude, Omicron Delta Kappa. Michael Carlton McDonough. Russell Raymond Nichol. Louis Pavelsa Jr., Senior Class Counsel. Joel Stephen Pelosi. Louis Pope. Russell Sean Reed. Eric Brian Rayhawk, Cum Laude. The second.
Jay Arthur Stutzman. Leonardo Tadalos. Frank J. Casitano. Christopher J. Williams. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Avionics Technology. Stephen Anthony Bryan. Cornelius Theodorus Emmer. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Professional Aeronautics. Justin Francis Adams, magna cum laude. David Andrew Brandt. Bradley D. Doe. Leslie Lennox Skian. Sergeant Robert Richard Matthews. John D. Sawinski. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the candidates within the College of Aviation Technology.
Gentlemen, I'd like to introduce Dr. William Graham, Acting Dean of the College of Engineering and Aviation Science. Dean Graham.
Mr. President, the faculty of the College of Engineering and Aviation Science are pleased to present the candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Science in Aeronautical Engineering, Bachelor of Science in Aerospace Engineering, Associate in Science in Aviation Business Administration, Bachelor of Science in Aviation Business Administration, Bachelor of Science in Aviation Maintenance Management, and Bachelor of Science in Computer Science with Aviation Applications. The candidates will now come to the platform to receive their diplomas.
Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Aeronautical Engineering. Hassel Avaliotakis, Sigma Gamma Dow. Kennepin Anomaly. Second Lieutenant Jeffrey Joseph Anthony. Robert J. Belga. Marcos Marcondes Cavallo. Thomas Michael Ellie. Mark B. Field. Neil Brian Gibbs. Joel John Hagen, Second Lieutenant, Sigma Gamma Tau, 1991. Michael Carl Oxenheim. Donald Raymond Hammond, second lieutenant, Sigma Gamma Tau. Kenneth Edward Kosiorowski, Sigma Gamma Tau. Sony Francis McAdams. Joao Pedro Machado. Paul Andrew Meyer. Ron Nguyen, Sigma Gamma Tau. Stephen Joseph O'Sullivan. Andres Manuel Villarres. Eric D. Peterson. Robert Petrenko. Richard Charles Siles, Jr. Stephen Todd Sipra. Martin Roger Theoret, Sigma Gamma Tau, Comali. Subramanian. Parish Oberon. John Henry Vaughn, fourth. Donna Ann Walsh. Daniel Paul Watchett. Robert S. Weeks. Patrick Anthony Olson. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Aerospace Engineering. Jerome Matthew James. Roman Hockman Hall. Anthony Joseph Rando, Jr. Matthew James Rosak. James W. Sobolewski. Brian Charles Swift, Sigma Gamma Tau, Cum Laude. Dennis G. Valley, Sigma Gamma Tau. Christy Swatek Whitson. Candidate for the degree of Associate in Science in Aviation Business Administration. Michelle G. Mann. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Aviation Business Administration. Henry Joy Hickley, Senior Class Counsel. Pamela Ann Blake, Senior Class Counsel. Christopher Lynn Box.
Dominic Don Crane, Sigma Gamma Tau Delta, senior class counselor. James Rod DeAndos, vice president, senior class counselor. Edward Lester Duff. Cho Han Tang. Leonard Hugh Goldberg. John Matthew Braille. Timothy Joseph Kohler. James Christopher Friction, magna cum laude. Lori Renee Matthews, senior class counselor. Robert Anthony McCabe, treasurer, senior class counsel, magna cum laude. Guy David Montaigne. Roland Elliott Warhead. Rebecca Ann Posley. Justine Marianne Reed, senior class counselor. Teresa Marie Rolls. Karen Marie Sanders, Sigma Tau Delta. John Henry Savoy. Gina Serrano. Jay Vikram Singh. Dane Allen Saw. James R. Stave. Second Lieutenant Mike Paul Selvig from Lawley, Omicron Delta Kappa, who was in 1991, senior class counselor. Peter Tufall. Heidi Ann Victoria Vladarczyk. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Aviation Maintenance Management. David W. Amber II. John Edward Brock. Michael Angelo DeFurio. Gary Roger Fortin. Robert Michael Mayer from Aubrey. Michael John Thompson. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Computer Science with Aviation Applications. Kevin Scott Hallows. Joseph Clinton Cook, Jr. Robert Joseph Grillo. David Edward Hanslick, cum laude. Gary Lewis Hope. Kenneth Joseph McKee, cum laude. Daniel Ann Roccarello. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the candidates within the College of Engineering and Aviation Science.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I am pleased to introduce the Provost of the College of Continuing Education, Dr. Leon Flanchard. Dr. Flanchard.
Ladies and gentlemen, the College of Continuing Education oversees residence centers in the United States and throughout the world. We are pleased to have a number of our students and faculty here today to participate with the Daytona Beach campus in their commencement ceremony. It is now my pleasure to introduce to you the Dean of the U.S. Division of the College of Continuing Education, Dr. Robert Hall. Dr. Hall?
Mr. President, the faculty of the College of Continuing Education are pleased to present the candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Science in Aviation Business Administration, Bachelor of Science in Aviation Maintenance Management, Bachelor of Science in Aeronautical Studies, Bachelor of Professional Aeronautics, and Bachelor of Science in Professional Aeronautics. The candidates will now come to the platform to receive their diplomas.
Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Aviation Business Administration. James Lewis Mia. Kimberly Marie Swisher. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Aviation Maintenance Management. Donald K. Phillips. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Aeronautical Studies. Douglas C. Coyle. Joanne Lucille Gladson. Frederick Howard Goodwin. Doreen L. Harrison. Somil Narendra Tripathi. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Professional Aeronautics. Ahmed Mohammed Rehan. Jack L. Fandenman. Deborah Lajuski McElroy. Candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Professional Aeronautics. Joe B. Bales. J. Charles Ballard. David Richard Barry. James Herschel Brown, cum laude. Michael Stephen Calvert. James Lincoln Coxwell Jr. Cameron Joseph Desiraj. Robert Dennis Dell, cum laude. Dawn Purvis Fogarty. Richard Franklin Galvin Jr. Donald A. Gerrish Jr. Andrew David Parker, cum laude. Bradford Leo Sipperly. Rodney J. South. Joseph Stupiello. Jeffrey R. Leininger. Concludes the undergraduate portion of the ceremony.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to introduce the acting dean of the graduate school, Dr. Richard Gibson, who will present the candidates for master's degrees. Dr. Gibson.
Mr. President, the faculty of the graduate school are pleased to present the candidates for the degrees of Master of Science in Aeronautical Engineering, Master of Aeronautical Science, Master of Aviation Management, and Master of Business Administration in Aviation. The candidates will now come to the platform to receive their diplomas.
Our mattresses are descended from the medieval hoods worn by professors in Paris and Bologna, and later in universities around the world. Today, I will hood on the first master's recipient, whose hood is symbolic of the achievement of all our successful graduate students. The other master's candidates received their hoods before the program began and are already wearing them. In the classical tradition, Embry-Riddle's hood reflects the school's colors, sky blue and sun gold. The eagles on the gold chevron are symbolic of the unique mission of Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. The field of graduate study is designated by the color of the velvet binding, orange for the Master of Science in Aeronautical Engineering, gold for the Master of Aeronautical Science degree, and brown for the Master of Business Administration in Aviation and Master of Aviation Management degrees.
Candidate for the degree of Master of Aeronautical Engineering, James Lewis Walker II. candidates for the degree of Master of Aeronautical Science. Hassan Saeed Kamal Al-Muzawa. Amy Aronoff. Charlie Virginia Brunsman. George John Tahulich. Marlowin Galloway. Arthur J. Hall. Richard L. Harrison. Captain G. Donald Kamer, Jr. William Anthony Colerus. George R. McCready. Michael D. McPherson. Charles Warren. C. A. Perry. Frederick A. Renton. James E. Taylor. Kenneth Wilson Way. Young Hawk Hugh. Candidate for the degree of Master of Aviation Management. Carlos Rafael Bustamante. Candidates for the degree of Master of Business Administration in Aviation. Kevin Olufemi Adesumoy. Dentarius Anderson, Sr. Patrice Felicia Bell. Farouk Baba, who's who, 1991. Kimberly Lorraine Cassingham. Jeanette Ellison. Susan Pettendorf Floyd. Elizabeth Francis Garcia. Master Sergeant Robert Allen Gatewood. Michael J. Houlihan. Tim A. Kuhn. Rhea B. Lewis. Irene C. McReynolds. declared quarry. Franco A. Owusu. Maria Fatamakira. Crystal F. Fayer. Thomas Arthur Roberts. Edward Joseph Rodwich. Mary L. Salazar. Warren Soule. Candidate for the dual degree of Master of Aeronautical Science and Master of Aviation Management. James Paul Hayes. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the candidates within the School of Graduate Science.
Dr. John Adams will be conferring the degrees from the Board of Trustees. Couldn't be with us today. In his place is Dr. John Morris, member of our Board of Trustees, who will represent the Board in conferring degrees on the candidates for graduation. Dr. Morris, will you join me at the podium, please?
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer on you as appropriate the associate degree, the associate in science degree, the bachelor's degree, the bachelor of science degree, the master's degree, and the master of science degree, with all of the rights, privileges, and honors and responsibilities appertaining thereto. Congratulations, graduates. You may now move your tassels from right to left. Go for it.
You may be seated, please. Dr. Morris will now conduct the conferring of the honorary degree.
Lieutenant General Charles R. Hamm comes to us today as Superintendent of the Air Force Academy in Colorado Springs, Colorado. General Hamm has risen to leadership in the United States military, in aviation, and in the field of education. Like most accomplished leaders, his ascent has been characterized by dedication and a genuine love for the professions he has served. General Hamm's career has been long and distinguished. His first operational assignment was in 1958 as an F-100 fighter pilot. During the early years of his career, he worked his way quickly through the ranks as a fighter pilot, weapons officer, instructor, and flight commander. His wartime service was exceptional, serving as flight commander with the 416th Tactical Fighter Squadron and flying 103 combat missions in Vietnam. His administrative ascent has been equally impressive. Since 1970, General Hamm has risen through several important military administrative positions, including that of Vice Commander of the Air Training Command at Randolph Air Force Base. His appointment to the leadership role at the Air Force Academy came in 1987. He has complemented these exceptional experiences with formal education of both the military and academic nature. His formal military education includes successfully completing programs at both the National War College and the Air Command and Staff College. Academically, he received his undergraduate degree from West Point in 1956 and a master's degree in political science from Auburn University in 1969. General Hamm's present assignment as superintendent of the Air Force Academy is then the culmination of an exceptional military career, the continuing pursuit of education, and well-tested leadership qualities. In this position, he's responsible for providing the finest military and academic education in the world to thousands of young men and women, and his efforts have certainly been recognized. General Hamm has been the recipient of 14 major military decorations, and in 1987, the promotion to Lieutenant General. Today, we are proud to add to this exceptional list recognition for his leadership in education as well. It's our pleasure, on behalf of the Board of Trustees and with the recommendation of the faculty, to award Lieutenant General Charles R. Hamm the degree Doctor of Aeronautical Science, Honoris Causa.
General Hamm, by the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, and on the recommendation of the faculty, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Aeronautical Science, Honoris Causa, with all of the rights, privileges, honors, and responsibilities pertaining to thereto. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. I am very honored to have this association with this great institution. Best of luck.
Congratulations, Dr. Hamm. The interest, dedication, and support of three groups of people play an important part in the success of our university: the Board of Trustees, the Board of Visitors, and the officers of the university. For the members of these groups who are with us today, please stand so that we may recognize them. Thank you.